Hello and welcome to another Nikko Media Tutorial. So, today we will make this one. I posted this yesterday or the day before yesterday, and I needed this clothes pin for a small project, and I needed an animation. So I made here an animation with user data. And you see it opens and closes, and what's interesting here is how the spring goes with it. So this is what I want to show you today, because I got many questions about this. Good. So if I make some mistakes now, please excuse it, because I have here a whiskey next to me, and you see, it's afternoon, so it's okay for whiskey. And today is my birthday, and I'm home alone, and I celebrate myself. And yeah, but I thought, why not making a tutorial in between? So, okay, let's start. And we start to model this clothes pin, which is it would be very easy with the volume builder. Simply make the rough object and pull out what you don't need, and that's it. I found on Google a stock photo for such a clothes pin, and so with volume builder you make this very rough thing and pull out what you don't need, and that's it. But we want to model this. It's really easy to do, so why not? Let's start with the polygon pen, with ME. This is the polygon pen, and I make a really rough thing here. So that, so let's make it, yeah, why not? So tuck, then here, yeah, so then here I cut. We can move the points later on, so it's not. And here, double click to close, and we have our thing here. I want this in X-ray, so. And now, what I want is make cuts next to these creases, so where they start and where they end. I do this with the plane cut, KJ. And drag here. If you want a straight cut, a really horizontal, so you hold your shift key and you see, whoop, 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 whoop. Okay, shift key, here a cut, and here a cut. It does not have to be exactly, because this is a wood glossy spin, and this has not to be exact, and we don't need exactly this form. What it is, so, and here a cut, there a cut. Okay, now I make the bigger ones here. Oh, here we have another small one. About here and here. And now the bigger ones. Here I need some more cuts. So I start here and here. And now I select these two edges here, and with MM I can cut them in half. So I hit MM and another time MM. So I have now here more things. This is what I want for the bigger ones. Same I do here, KJ, and somewhere like here, let's say it starts. Take these two and here we have KK, right here, cut as well, so. And make here MM, MM, okay. Nice, that's it so far. The next step is, here I could use a cut as well, where this rounding starts here, okay. Good. And on the other side here. KG. Maybe let's make this a little later. Yeah, let's make this cut a little later. Good. Now I hit KK for a line cut and cut along. So it starts here, to this rounding starts here, and I want to cut the height of these creases. So go to here, and go to here. As I said, you don't have to be exact because you can move the points later on to every time. Sometimes your cut get lost when you do this. This is when you, when the auto save is turned on, and when it's auto saves, and then it disables the cut here. That is, but then you simply continue. So, okay. And now, go. See here. Okay. Same I do from here. Here I start somewhere here where the rounding is. And on the big ones, I don't cut just through. I go around them, so like this here. Okay. Here we have a smaller cut, so I can make check. Here again we have a bigger, so let's go like this. Great. And here we can go until, let's say, this rounding here about. Okay, nice. I see we lost here a cut, so let's go. Okay, that should work. Let's go down here and disable the X-ray. Yeah, now let's move some points. We can now move. Let's bring back the X-ray. So we can now. This a little exact, so something like that. For me, the shape really does not matter a lot, so just that we have something. And here we make another cut, KK, and let's go from here to here. To here. Okay. Now let's move this guy to here. So. Okay, this guy to here. You see, this is a very relaxing work. At least for me. Maybe you think so too. You don't have to make it quick. Let's take it here. Is the time what you need? Don't rush. Simply, it's like a meditation. Okay, the whiskey starts to do his work. So, okay. Take these points here and drag them over to here. So, okay, should look a little natural. Now I go in polygon mode. And this delete this small increases here. So. Whoop, whoop. Okay. And that should it be. Save it. Don't forget to save. And now let's put this in a subdivision surface and let's see what we get. I'll select it and hit Alt key on the keyboard. Check subdivision surface. That looks fine. That looks fine. That looks fine. Yeah, it works. Let's see. Here we are almost perfect. But this is too round. So when something is too round, we need more cuts. KJ, I make here a cut. And here a cut. That should help here. You see, that's perfect. Same we do here. Here a cut. And here a cut. No time at the moment here. Okay. And here. Here we have to do something. So make the same. Cut. 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 Looks better. Go in point mode. And now let's drag the points a little around. But I want that this looks rounder than the original one. Oh, that looks quite nice. Okay. Here we need another cut, but let's see, that looks not so bad. And here we make a cut here, KK. Of course, you know, meanwhile, as closer this space is between the points, as sharper the edge will be. See, that's good. It's almost okay for me here. But what I want is take these 2 points. What's going on here? So, and hit T for scale, and I scale these 2 points a little together so we get a little more rounding here. It looks then like this. Do I like here sharper edge? Yes, I do. So, KJ, from here to here, yep, that's it. So let's go to up to D to here, let's see what we have here. Sharper edges for sure, KJ. Okay. These two T for scale and scale them a little together. So. Okay, we can take all of them and move them a little down here. That's okay. Here the same KJ. Whoops, whoops. Whoops, whoops. Okay, and then we have this guy here. This rounding is perfect. I want here that the spring sits in. Maybe let's bring this a little more down here. So. And here with the KJ, so let's see what we can do here. First, I want to make here some making some space. I want to move this edge here up, but if you imagine this edge maybe goes like this or something else, if you just move it up, you destroy your shape here. If you want to do something like this, use the slide tool. This is MO. It's a slide tool, and here you can do whatever you want. It never will destroy your shape here. I want to just have some space here. So that it looks more even, the whole thing here. And I don't want to make a cut here again. This would tell, let's see. When I make here a cut, KJ, and make a cut here. The problem, you see, this is not really a round edge here now. This is a more than it looks not really nice here. For this, I select this again and MN for the solve. There is another way we can solve this. So what I do here is KK for line cut. I make a cut here. And then I make a cut here like this. And now I delete this edge in the middle here. So, and I cannot dissolve it. That would destroy this. And I want to melt this edge here. The melt command is UC or UZ, UZ on the keyboard, and you get this. And now when we have this, you see we get a very nice rounding here. This is much better than before. You can do this, of course, on the other things here as well, when you don't want to have these cuts next to them. Here I want to do the same, so but I make another KJ, and I try to make something like that. It looks almost like a quad here, so like, yeah. That it looks for the eye comfortable. So KK, go from here to here. Here another cut. And UC, and we should have here a nice, yeah, very nice thing where our spring will rest later on. So that we are done here. I like it like it is. Yeah, save it. And now we need some thickness, of course. You could make a polygon, select all your polygons with Control A and D for extrude and extrude it. This would be no problem in this case, but I want to be flexible. So if I want to change later something, let's say that the thickness or the depth of this or whatever. So I use here, so let's go out of this. I want to use here the Pi tools from Maxon. This extension, it is the Pi parametric tools. We have here the Pi extrude generator. These Pi parametric tools you will find on the Maxon Labs, so the address is labs.maxon.net, but you will find this also on my website, and the link to my website you will find in the description. And so I selected my polygon and hold my Alt key and click on the Pi extrude generator, and you see immediately it does something. Let's make it 40, and we need caps, whoop, and that is it. Here I am totally flexible. I can change this whenever I want. Here that looks okay, but a little too smooth here. The reason is we have no subdivisions here. So you see, here in between we have no subdivisions, and we should have some. So let's bring in some subdivisions. This should be okay. And this looks now much better. You see the difference? If I go here to zero, it looks and when you go up here, you get more shape thing going on. So, okay. That looks all nice so far. And this looks a little sharp, this edge here. So how can we change this? you know, as closer the space here, this is sharper the edge. So that means we should go with this edge a little up, with this edge a little down. But I wanted to show you how I do this. I go in point mode and select these points, and I want to come on, scale them. So T for scale, but if you scale them like this, it would scale in every direction. I want to scale from this point so that the axis should be here, so that it scales just here, here, and here. So how do we do this? We hold simply our L key, L, and click on this point. Now you see the axis is on this point. And now I can drag. This point doesn't move, and this is exactly what I want. I can simply make this bigger. And to see how what this does is, it makes our edge smoother. And this is exactly what I want. Same here. T for scale. Hold your L key. Click on this point and make it a little bigger, so that we have the same space here and here. And now this looks. Let's go in the other direction. Let's go in the other direction that we have the same optic here. So let's go to this minus 50. And now I have it here in front. Okay. All the other things looking really nice here. Save it. The only thing that I want, so that I have quite the same distance everywhere. I want to make here maybe two cuts and here one cut, or here maybe three cuts. We will see. I go to my polygon mode, edge mode. I select this edge. Let's make it without subdivision surface. Select this and hit MM. So this makes it halves it. Then again MM and again MM. And maybe once more. Why not? We don't have a lot of this object, so. And this is just looks more even. I like this more. So if you have thousands and thousands, of course you look that you have as few polygons as you can have. But in this case, it doesn't matter. In this case, even the volume builder doesn't matter. So. Good. So we are ready so far. Next point is we want this whole thing in a symmetry object, of course. So we make a symmetry object. Symmetry. Where is my symmetry? And drag this guy in the symmetry object. Great. One, take the polygon and bring this a little. Okay, so far so good. The next step is we want a spring here in between. Maybe bring it a little more. The spring is round. We can bring them together later with rotation. So let's go to here, and I hide with Shift V. I come to my viewport settings, and here I can disable the background here. Then hide NI to see just the isobarms. This is better for our eyes. So let's make a sip of the whiskey. Cheers, you all. Good single malt at 1 p.m. Gut, wir need a helix. Tiefer scale. Scale it down. Bring it up to somewhere like here. Ah, that's almost perfect. We need it a little smaller because we want to make a sweep here. Okay. Nice. Nice, 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 nice. So, but the helix should be here because it starts here. I try to be with this rounding here on this edge, but this doesn't matter. It's just. And then the height, I go to here, so that I have the other rounding here, so that this rounding is now not here. So let's make it like this and make it maybe a little higher. Bring it. That should almost work. Okay. And I want double the end angle, so times two, let's say. Yep. That's fine. And let's bring this in a sweep. So for a sweep, we need a profile spline as well. So make a circle and try it with 4 centimeter maybe. And put this all in the sweep. I select my circle, go to here, hold my Alt key, sweep, and we need this as well. So looks great. Maybe it's a little too thick, so I go to tiefer scale and make them 20 by 20. Perfect. And now we have a problem. This end here should be exactly in the other direction, so because I want it here and it should go down here. Good. To make it in the different direction, you cannot simply say, hey, no problem, I rotate it, yeah, but then you have exactly the same, so that's does not matter. So what you have to do is go here and set minus. That's how you do it. And now this should point to here. So let's see. And this is the end radius. No, 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 no. It's here the end angle, I think. Yeah. I bring this here, so that it points down. If you imagine a straight line, it should go somewhere here. Oops. I think this works here, and on the other side the same, of course. This should point to this guy here. So this is the start angle. Where are you? Oh, here is it. Okay, this should point. Oh, that could work. Something like that. Okay. Let's see. Okay. Now, what I have to do is I have to make the helix editable here. Because I cannot go here and just go longer, this is not possible. But I don't want to lose it, so I make a null object. Backup. And drag a copy of this helix inside here. Hide it. So if something happens, if I do something wrong with the converted thing, we have the original one. See on the keyboard, and now we go in point mode, and I take this one point here. This is this point here, and I think this is the wrong direction. Camera, go to back. Yeah, that's the right one. I go from here to here. Go in spline mode. And you see, we can draw a spline now. I go to here. I try to here. And chuck, point. And now, you see, okay, this guy should be here normally. But we know if this is here, we have to go in this direction so that we follow this. We can make this a different. We can go to here and drag it out to here so that it comes straight down here. Okay. And now again, here I go inside here somewhere, like a little less, so something like this. Okay. See, this is wrong as well, so okay, good. Let's see how this looks. It looks a little weird. We have here these two tangents here, and we can move them with the moving tool. So when we say You don't see it so much when you have it in the subdivision surface later. This should be fine. Maybe should drag this. And it should be okay. So. Let's see how this looks, and we need here a chamfer, something like that. How does this look when we put this in a sweep? Looks very nice. Yeah, here we have a little thing. Let's see if we can make this nicer. This is okay for me. When I say it's okay for me, you know me. Now it's almost okay for me. There must be. Another guy. Yeah, it's really not necessary to make it like this, but so exactly. But I think as more we do here, as more we destroy. So I think it's better to stop here. Good. Then. Let's do the same on the other side. Camera front. This point here. This is this point, yeah. Go down to here. See how this looks here now. Okay, I hit escape key and bring this to here. So this go straight down. Somewhere like here. again will not. Where is it? Ah, here it works, look. Yeah, here it works. So, chamfer. The same like before, so apply. Okay. Save this. And we have this sweep here, which looks great. Yeah, I stay with this now. Let's see. Not really. Yeah, okay. Save. We have our thing here going. Now, to rotate this thing here correctly, we have to do something. If I go here and rotate now, this wouldn't look quite nice. You see, that's not what we want. We need the axis of this polygon in the middle of the spring here. Simple. Go to E, so to move to the seat better. I hold my L key. L. You can also click on this in the axis mode. You see, when I hold my L key and you look at this, L, 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 L. And when I hold my L key and release it, it looks like this. So, but first what I can do is go in there and try to reset the PSR of this. This does not work of the axis. Let's see the position of this axis. Zero. Okay, that's what I want. Right, let's stay in axis mode, why not? And I go up with this axis to about in the middle of. You know, what I said, it has not to be exactly, but so I think between this. This could work. Out of the axis, and we see it if we rotate now. As you see, it rotates along this spring, and this is perfect. This is exactly what I want. So I want to rotate this first, so that it's closed here. So they almost closed. Okay. This is now here in the coordinates. Let's go to minus one. Now they are fully closed. I don't want. Why not? Fully closed is okay. But I don't want to work with an uneven number. I want to work when I animate something. I want to work with zeros. So I go to the freeze transformation here, and I say freeze rotation. That sets the rotation here to zero and remembers here the value from here. So when I go freeze, see the value is here, but I can work here with zero in the animation. This is what I want. Good. And the animation will be how far we will go from zero to, let's see. Something like that, so they come together here. 0 to 9, let's see. Okay, this is just that I want to know for the keyframing. So we can make a save. We can make now a user data to make this pair via a slider. For this, I make a own thing here for the espresso. You can put the espresso tag on whatever you want. It doesn't matter where it is. But I make a new null object. Name it user data, so everyone knows what's going on. And here I select this and I go to user data, manage user data. So I make a new group, so I'm otherwise that and drag it out of here, otherwise the new tab here later would be named user data. This is not what I want. And open close, so that's open close. Okay. And what I need is a simple slider, a simple slider from 0% to 100%. So what I need is add data, a float slider, and percent from 0 to 100 in one step, step one. Wait a second, this is exactly what I want. We have to do nothing here. Okay. And now you see when I go to my user data here, I have an own thing with user data and with this slider here. This is great. And now we need a very, 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 very little espresso. So I go right click, programming the espresso. And it's really, really simple. Don't be afraid. I drag in my user data null here because on this we have the user data. Go to open close and drag in this data. Let's name this data as well. So user data, manage user data, and name it slide. So it's a slider, so let him slide. Okay. And now I drag this simple here in the red corner. This is the outgoing thing. And this should affect our polygon here. I drag in my polygon. And what should it affect? It should affect here our rotation. Which rotation was this? It was the B rotation. This is heading, pitching, banking. So the B rotation, just drag in the B rotation here. Good. So now, of course, it has to know what shall I do with this. We want to go from 0% is 0 degrees, and 100% should be 9 degrees. So this is because I need this 1 till 100 later on for the spring. So okay, this is, we need a range mapper. What tells this thing something? So I go here to the search range mapper, and in the range mapper I say the input range is percent. This is slider, it's from 0 to 100%, and the output should be degrees. This is from 0 to 9 degrees. And here I tell it, okay, 0% is 0 degrees, this is okay. 100% should be 9 degrees. So that's it. Now let's connect this input output. So, and now when we go to our user data here, on 0%, we have, let's open another thing. Let's open this. So this is this, and here I bring in this so that we can see the coordinates here. So at 0%, we have 0 degrees. Now we go up to 100%, you see. 100%, we have 9 degrees. So in this slider, we can easily animate. Huh? So this is the first thing. Now, how can we do this that our spring goes with this animation. Good. Firstly, I want this slide here. I don't want to go every time in my user data. I'd simply drag this slide in my viewport, but I want it in the perspective mode. Drag it in the view. No, come on, drag it in the viewport. What's going on with my? Do I have to bring it from here? Open slide. Ah, it's twice here. Remove. Okay. If you wanna move some thing here in the viewport, some of these sliders, you have to push your control key, and now you can. I just wanna open slider. Okay, and I wanna see it always. Good. So now when I drag it here, you see, I don't have to search every time somewhere. Good. Now let's go to the spring. The spring. Firstly, I see we are not exactly here on the thing. So I go to my helix here and I select these points here down. So I can, let's make it without the sweep so you see what I did. I select it with the chamfer. I select these points. So that means let's hide the subdivision here. These points here are selected. And I bring them a little together. T for scale. So that means I have to bring this back here. T for scale. And just until it's on here. So we don't see it here, so this is such a little movement, you see that it does not. Okay. Oops. Save it. And what I want, because I see it now, if I want to. Should we make this a little thicker? It is spring. This can we can make later, but I think it's okay like this. I want here in the sweep. A little caps here. Capsy, capsy, capsy. Yeah, something like that. Three segments. Here we see it looks okay. Okay. What we need now is we need a second helix. I copy this helix now. And I hide this sweep for the moment. Oh no, yeah, that's better. Okay. And on this helix, I bring the points here to this state of the soil. Drag this to here. And I take the other ones. We don't see it now because of, but when I select it, we have it here. Oops. So like here, okay. That's good so far. I'm happy with this. Maybe we should bring these guys. That we won't see this, so this is not really. This is not really a problem. But if you want, you can do everything for a problem. So, and now I want to change the positions from this helix to this helix and back. This we can make with a pose morph. We don't have to see this helix here. And this helix, I give a pose morph. Simulation, not simulation, rigging, sorry. And pose move. Pose move, I wanna have the points here. And the target will be this guy here. See? What we have now is this animation. And this is exactly what we need. So I go here to I go here to animate, and I want to animate the strength. So we are here on 0, and I want here 0. So the simplest thing is now we go to our expressor here. This is really simple. We take our pose morph here, and we want to animate this strength of this thing here. So we don't need a range map or something else because the slider is in percent. Here we have percent. We simply connect these two guys. And now when we move our slider, see what's going on. So I see here, okay, this looks not nice. I simply can go to my helix here. And maybe I have to make it. Okay. And drag this up here. So somewhere like this, same here. Let's see how this looks like. Okay. That's it. Save it. And we have our closest bin open and closed. Okay, and yeah, I think I don't have to texture this now because, as I said, you can download this project file on Patreon with textures, and there we will see how it did. But it is a simple cubic mapping. The only thing you have to do to be aware is if you make a cubic mapping and your animator something, I will show you this shortly. Let's make here Shift F8. Here, if I have some wood textures, it doesn't matter, just for showing it. And bring this on a polygon, and I want to make here a cubic mapping. So I have this now. And if you have a cubic mapping and you do this, you see the texture stays in place. This texture does not move. Yeah, on this side, yes, but it moves because it's in the symmetry here. But not on the other side. What you can do is go for the octane the same. So go to here, material, text, pin texture, or the pin material, and record it. And now it works. That's it. See, so how easy, so easy it is. And now, yeah, if you have questions, requests, complaints, whatever, please write me in the comments or on my Facebook site or on our Facebook group or wherever you can find me. I hope you liked this one. And yeah, my next tutorial will come soon, of course. And yeah, I will drink now another whiskey, I think. Yeah, a little bit here. Yeah, cheers, friends. Yeah, that's good. And yeah, poor, what should I say? Stay safe, stay healthy, please. Please, 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 please. I need you guys. And Yeah, if you have some ideas what we can do and so, just let me know. And hope we come back to a normal life soon, but we will see. And honestly, the lockdown is not the worst thing ever for me because it's a little calm down and so that's not bad. But I don't need it forever, so. Good. That's it now, and I wish you all the best here from Austria, Vienna, and yeah, please. Yeah, please. Please. You know, it's my birthday. Maybe you want to donate. You will find all the links you need in the description for PayPal. And if you want to support me on Patreon, where you can download all the project files and even more when I make some private work and I put it on to download when I'm allowed to. You can download and textures and whatever. And of course, patrons, questions from patrons, and so I have always advances. So they're not advanced. You know, they come first. yeah. Okay, that's enough. Bye bye. Have a wonderful day and a good start in the week in the new one. And tschüss und baba.